Hey there, rock stars. Are you new to songwriting and want to know more about rhyming, rhyme schemes, types of rhymes, what rhymes with rhymes? In this video, I'm sharing a snippet from my Sync songwriting workshop with you that covers all of this in depth.
Roll it.
One of the most useful tools in our lyrical toolbox is the rhyme. Now, just like a lot of people feel like they're not very good at rhythm, I've had a lot of people feel like they're not very good at rhyming. And maybe it's because both of those words are spelled ridiculously. If you feel like you're not good at rhyming, I'm going to show you there's some tools and there's some tips that make it so easy. A rhyme is defined as a word, syllable, or phrase that has a similar sound to another word, syllable, or phrase. Cat and bat and all of that. Want to see the master of rhymes at work? I'm going to give you two examples. Dr. Seuss and Eminem. First, we're going to look at a passage from Dr. Seuss from Fox and Socks. I'll read that for you. But then, I'm going to have Eminem share with you his rhyming styling. When beetles fight these battles in a bottle with their paddles, and the bottle's on a poodle and the poodle's eating noodles, they call this a muddle, puddle, tweedle, poodle, beetle, noodle, bottle, paddle, battle.
I'm out my ramen noodle. We have nothing in common, poodle. I'm a Doberman. Pinch yourself in the arm and pay homage, pupil. It's me. My honesty's brutal, but it's honestly futile if I don't utilize what I do, though, for good at least once in a while. So I want to make sure somewhere in the chicken scratch I scribble and doodle.
Now let's look at rhyme schemes. In order to show you these different patterns, we're going to use letters, and each letter represents a rhyme. You see an A, and then you see another A. Well, those two lines rhyme together. Same thing with a B and a B, or a C and a C. Whereas an A and a B, well, those two lines, they end with a different rhyme. Do you follow? So, for an example, you might have a rhyme scheme like A, B, C, B. Whereas A doesn't have another A corresponding with it, so nothing else rhymes with the end of that line. And then you have a B, and that B rhymes with the fourth line. And then you have C, so C doesn't rhyme with either A or B. Or you can have something like A, B, A, B. And in this pattern, every line has a corresponding rhyme. Or you can do A, A, B, B. For a chorus of a song, it's very common to have a pattern of A, 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 A. And I think the reason this is because, again, the chorus needs to be something that is easy for people to sing, so they don't have to learn a new rhyme, and it all kind of sounds really good together. Here are two more interesting rhyme schemes. A, B, B, A, or A, 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 B. There are a lot of different rhyme scheme patterns, and to help you out, I've added a rhyme scheme chart below this video. You can have the same rhyme scheme throughout your song, or each part of your song can have different rhyme schemes. So the verse might be AAB, and the chorus might be ABAB, and the bridge might be ABCB. So you can have a lot of fun, you can be really inventive, and you can even come up with your own. You're not limited at all when it comes to rhymes. Not only are there a lot of different rhyme schemes, there's also different types of rhymes. The type of rhyme that people most think about is the perfect rhyme, when a sound sounds exactly the same. So for instance, I've been waiting on your call, you keep wanting me to fall, where call and fall sound exactly the same. Rhymes can be imperfect as well. And this is called a near rhyme, when the two sounds aren't exact, but they still sound oddly similar. So for instance, how and smile. You know, those sounds are actually not at all the same, but they kind of sound the same. That's a near rhyme. A complex rhyme is a rhyme that exists across several syllables, where you can take two different phrases and rhyme them together. Here's what I mean by that. I took a picture of a lake and hooked a fisher in the face. You see, there are multiple places that rhymes are taking place within these two phrases. Now, these can be a little bit more tricky to construct, but well worth the effort, in my opinion. Most rhymes come at the end of the phrase, and these are called end rhymes. But you can also put a rhyme in the middle of the phrase, and that's called an internal rhyme. The headline screams with the news. The deadline for us is today. A red line is drawn on the floor. The next time we will start with love. Ready to take things to the next level? Experiment with all these different types of rhymes within your writing. Near rhymes, complex rhymes, internal rhymes. Here's a great tip for writing lyrics. You can actually use rhymes to help you create new lines. Ha! Once you have a line that you like and you know the rhyme pattern or the rhyme scheme, you can work backwards from that rhyme and create a new line. This will help when I show you. So let's say your rhyme scheme is AA, and your first line is Everybody Dreams of Fame. Now I can go to a site like Rhyme Zone and I can type in fame and look at all the different types of rhymes that rhyme with fame. And you can even do more than one syllable, two syllables, three syllables, whatever. But after looking through all these, I feel like the one that might help inspire me is shame. So I'm gonna put that in place. And now I'm gonna do something, something, something shame. Here was my quick result. Everybody dreams of fame, but no one wants to deal with shame. That second line was inspired entirely from the rhyme.
How do you make money as a songwriter? Because people don't buy music anymore. Did you know that it takes 30,000 streams on Spotify just to make 100 bucks? But the truth is, the way that we consume music is always changing. When the vinyl record came out, it killed the sheet music industry. Sure, it was a record year for record sales, but it was a sheet year for sheet music. So you can sit around and whine about it like a poo-poo diaper dummy, or you can accept that the only true constant is change and learn to adapt. But alas, there is a place where people still buy music. I'm of course talking about TV shows, films, commercials. If you are interested in making passive income with your music, then do I have a gift for you? Join me for Sync It In, a free training session where I show you how to get started writing songs for TV and film. In this free course, I show you why writing for sync is viable today. The different types of opportunities, the difference in writing songs for sync, how to produce your tracks, the obstacles you will face along the way, and also the new bliss of establishing a steady stream of royalties. Who doesn't want a steady stream, am I right?